I'll try and see if I can explain my thought processes to how I got to the point of wanting to ask you a question about this. Just over there, which you can't actually see, is where I feed the birds every day. And also, around the base of the tree, a load of mole holes. And I don't feed the moles. In fact, if anything, I'm doing my damnedest to get rid of them. I don't want to do them any harm, but they are really irritating because they leave annoying little heaps all over the place. And I was thinking about the notion that to them, in some respects at least, I'm a god. You know, I make the birds' life an awful lot easier. They wait in the morning for me to come out and feed them with, you know, great excitement. And I make their lives, as I said, easier. And I seem to smile upon birds as this crap god. And yet I make the moles' lives a bit of a misery. You know, the moles are the ones condemned to a difficult life. I mean, they could even go somewhere where it would be less difficult, but they don't seem to want to. But then we feel the same as humans, don't we? That we want to live where we want to live and we want to do what we want to do. So that was an initial thought. And then I was thinking about how we do, one way or another, consider ourselves either to be gods or to be God's mouthpiece or representative. We consider that we have dominion over the earth and all that lives on it. We feel we have the right to do what the hell we like with it. We feel we understand it, that we're superior to all other living things, and therefore that we should have more choice and influence. And if we don't think that, then we consider ourselves to be God's special people, and that we should, again, you know, we can pronounce, we are either gods or representatives of God or gods. And then I moved on in my thoughts to the notion of pantheism and the fact that there are numerous gods in that context. And they all essentially, at least, represent or seem to represent particular human traits. So you might call on a particular god if you really ultimately required that kind of quality to come into your life, and therefore essentially that you were portraying that quality. So in some respects you're summoning something from within yourself, whether it be strength to do something or resist something, or to dare to think of yourself as potentially successful, or, you know, all these various different things, or to manifest love in your life. So one way or another, you know, whether we are, whatever we consider ourselves to be, we do kind of consider ourselves to be gods. And I was thinking, well, if we are, we do think that, then what crap gods we really are. You know, we say, some people will say, you know, if God lets this happen, then I don't want to believe in a god like that, or worse to that effect. And yet we are the people that are doing those things. So that only we can make a difference. And while a lot of us, not all, but a lot of us, try and make the efforts to change things for the better, we still are pretty inconsistent and contradictory in the way we behave. You know, we look at the things that we do that we think are good and emphasise those, and sometimes we completely fail to notice the things that we do which are harmful and damaging. So what I would like to ask you, and I've yet to kind of come to any conclusions myself, because there, you know, there's not just this kind of contradictory behaviour I have with the nature in my garden, but I have all sorts of other contradictory things that I could probably come up with, and I'll have to think about it and I'll come back to you on that. But if you were a crap god, what would you be? You know, what quality or contradictions or behaviour do you think has influence on the world in a kind of godlike fashion? Or, you know, how would you cast yourself as a god? What god of paganism or pantheism would you be? I don't mean that exists. I mean, you know, if you were a new god, a bit like voodoo has, you know, different gods, current gods or very recent gods. What role would you cast yourself in? If someone were going to summon you, what would they be summoning you for? I'd be really interested in your answer. Thanks a lot.